Machine learning has a lot of opportunities in the diagnosis of brain tumors. I think the main advantage with machine learning is that when you have lots of data, it can learn from previous patterns and help, based on previous patterns, it can help with the prediction of diagnosis of brain tumors as well as for the prediction of which patients are going to do well potentially and how they're going to respond and so on. So. Radiogenomics is the concept where you can take the word comes essentially from the amalgamation of radio, which is about the images, and genomics is obviously genomics. And so the idea with radiogenomics is potentially there's a lot of information in the image itself that reflects the underlying biology and the genomics of the tumor. And so very often one can use the image to sort of predict the molecular subtypes of the tumor, or one can take the information in the image itself as along with the genetic information to add more the ability to predict better predictions and things like that as well. So, deep learning is a very exciting field. There's potentially a lot of hype around it, and so I think a really good something that people should be aware of is being able to distinguish between what is real and what is hype, and so trying to sort of look at the studies that are being published with a very critical eye to seeing if they're being done with statistical rigor as well as essentially having good practice in terms of how you train your models, how you do the evaluation. Just sort of digging deep into the methods, I think would be a useful thing. Deep learning is very powerful, but I think there's, as you can see here, there's a lot of excitement and some hype about it, and so being able to separate what's real from the hype, I think, is probably important.